Hey guys, it's Stefan from the Sane Pentecostal. I hope you're doing really well. So I wanted to hit on something today that it jumped out at me because I was rereading these passages of scripture in Corinthians, and it just gripped my heart, man. And just to preface it, oftentimes when we're thinking about like who's qualified as a minister, who's qualified to be preaching the word, teaching the word, that kind of thing, we rightly think about typically two categories. We think about their personal behavior, their experience, their life, and their doctrine, right? We're thinking about their life. Are they known by people? Do they have experience? Were they deacons before they became elders? Were they had hands laid on them by a local church? Did they try to promote themselves, or did other people lift them up? All this stuff is really important, right? Because you have to be known, people have to know you, the Lord has to point out to the church that you have a calling on your life, they raise you up in the Lord, right? Et cetera, et cetera. We see that all over scripture. I've talked about that in other videos, and that's so true, right? You can't be just some rando on the internet. Taking one of them diploma mills, or I'm just going to set up my own church in, a parking lot or something, and then that's just the way it is, and it's basically just you, and you're trying to start your own thing when there's no reason to do it, right? No one sent you. You're not like in the middle of Africa somewhere where there's no Christians around. You're in an area where there's tons of Christians, and yet you don't have any fellowship with them. I mean, okay, so we understand that. Now, the other thing is doctrine. Now, about doctrine, 1 Corinthians 15, the next chapter after what I'm about to read, absolutely central, right? You got to understand. I might just read this real quick because it's such a good overview. Obviously, it's the Word of God, but it's so clear and to the point about what the central things are that define the Christian faith, okay? So I'll read it in the King James just because I have it here. 1 Corinthians 15, moreover, brethren, this is the Apostle Paul speaking. I declare unto you the gospel which I preached unto you, which also you have received, and wherein you stand. So, this is the gospel he's declaring. You've heard it, and this is sufficient for you to stand, right? By which you are also saved. So, you stand in it, you're saved by it, if you keep in memory what I preached unto you, unless you have believed in vain. For I delivered unto you, first of all, that which I also received, how that Christ died for our sins according to the Scriptures, and that he was buried, and that he rose again in the third day according to the Scriptures, and that he was seen of Cephas, which is Peter, and then of the 12, and after that he was seen of about 500 brethren at once, etc., etc. Okay? The life, death, burial, resurrection of Christ, right? The divinity of Christ, the Trinity, all this stuff. Okay, great. Amen. Praise God. Need to have that nailed down. Bum bum, right? But that isn't all. Let me just say that. That isn't all. It's not enough just to have a good life and just to have that foundational bit in 1 Corinthians 15 memorized or understood to be qualified to be teaching on the things of God and the things of the Spirit. No, you don't have to take my word for that, okay? What I want you to do is go back and reread 1 Corinthians chapters 12 to 14 as a singular flow of thought, because it really is. It just 12 is here are the gifts of the Spirit. 13 is here's why you should desire the gifts, because it's from love and for love. They operate by love. I mean, the reason you want the gifts of the Spirit is because you love people. You want that person to hear a word from the Lord. You want that person to be healed. You want that person to be encouraged. You want that person to have a miracle in their life. Now, if you don't love people and you don't care, or you think you're more spiritual than God because God doesn't care, good for you, I guess. But let me just read what the Apostle Paul has to say. And there's a little catch in here for anybody who would try to twist the scripture out of sorts and make it be about something that it's not about. So let's just read it. I'm going to read this in the Amplified Bible, because I think it brings out some nuances that you may not get in the King James. I'm also going to read it a second time in the NET Bible because it does the same kind of thing. All right. So this is 1 Corinthians chapter 14, starting at verse 38. Okay. 1 Corinthians chapter 14, starting at verse 38. Listen carefully. If anyone disregards or does not recognize that this is a commandment of the Lord, he is disregarded and not recognized. He is one whom God knows not. That's heavy. Okay, that's their bracketed interpretation. So not only is he disregarded and not recognized, like as a teacher or a spiritual person, but they're going on to say, this is somebody that God didn't even know who this guy is. I'm like, okay. So to conclude, my brethren, earnestly desire and set your heart on prophesying. And they interpret that as being inspired to preach and teach and to interpret God's will and purpose. And do not forbid or hinder speaking in unknown tongues. But all things should be done with regard to decency and propriety in an orderly fashion. Okay, now obviously, the idea that prophesying here just means preaching is ridiculous. It's not all it means, okay? But the emphasis here is, if you're not going to acknowledge that what Paul is saying here is from the Lord, neither should you be acknowledged as someone who's qualified to teach. The NET makes this really clear. I really like it. It's a very interesting phraseology. So just hear this real quick. If anyone considers himself a prophet or a spiritual person, he should acknowledge that what I write to you is the Lord's command. If someone does not recognize this, he is not recognized. So then, brothers and sisters, be eager to prophesy and do not forbid anyone from speaking in tongues, and do everything in a decent and orderly manner. Okay, now why am I saying that? Because the Apostle Paul doesn't seem to have any kind of shyness about saying, you think you're qualified to be teaching in the church? Okay, so if you're going to forbid speaking in tongues and you're going to forbid prophecy, you are not qualified to be teaching in the church. That's what that scripture is saying. Specifically, that's what it's saying. All right? And I know that's going to hurt a lot of people's feelings. And they're going to get real mad and start manifesting all kinds of evil spirits. Going to get real angry because y'all want this cessationist, humanist, completely unbelieving, completely carnal reading of the Bible. When Paul is saying the Spirit of God does supernatural stuff in the church through his people, yes, it should be decent and in order, for sure. Don't come wasting my time quoting me whatever Benny Hinn's doing or some dumb that, I mean, I don't have nothing to do with him. I'm talking about in a local church. This is our commandment to us in a local church, how you practice it in a local church, in your local context. There is no internet worldwide church that doesn't work, okay? I'm talking about people who are, again, you know their life, you know their doctrine, and they're encouraging you to do what the Bible says. And what's the Bible say? Covet to prophesy and forbid not to speak in tongues. Have it in order. He goes on to say that next, but that's what it is. And by the way, I'm going to hit it one last time on this and leave it at this. I want you to hear this because it's so important. Paul says explicitly, clearly, if someone does not acknowledge this is the commandment of the Lord, they are not to be acknowledged as a teacher in the church. Full stop. Whoever your favorite preacher is, if they don't want to acknowledge this as the commandment of the Lord, you need to not acknowledge them as a teacher and move on. Found in a local church, pray and fast, ask God to get you in a local body that obeys the word of God and will teach you not just to walk in the fruit of the Spirit, but the gifts of the Spirit to the glory of God and the good of the body of Christ. God bless you.